I'm Ted Conover. I'm a journalist and nonfiction writer. I live in New York. I'm known for books in which I participate in the lives of my subjects. My book, New Jack, describes a year I spent working as a guard at a famous New York prison called Sing Sing. I got a job there after the state told me I could not visit the prison more than one time, and I couldn't talk to officers because their work was very sensitive. And I felt that was a bad answer because prisons in the United States are a big problem. They're very expensive, and we put a lot of people in them for long periods of time, especially young men of color. And this is a growing problem. It was a problem even 20 years ago when I got the job. It hasn't gotten much better. Yeah. I worked in order to understand what prison does to a worker. There are stereotypes of guards as brutes who just beat people all day. But I thought, nobody grows up like that. So does something happen to them when they start to work in a place like that? And does something happen to the prisoners when they live in that environment for a long time? So by participating, I gained information that I couldn't learn any other way. Journalists do interviews, but I wanted to understand through my own experience. So the book is a narrative. It begins at the beginning, and it takes the reader through the many months I worked there. I was frightened much of the time, and I also don't think I was as good a guard as some of the others, right? Because they understood it better. I had been to college, and I think college made it harder to do that job because I kept wanting to ask questions of the prisoners and learn about their background and how they got there. And the job is easier if you don't ask questions, if you just keep a stony face and keep it impersonal. And the guards say, don't treat your family like prisoners, but it's very hard not to have some of that in your mind. Because all day long, people are challenging you and trying to intimidate you physically. And I'm not as big as lots of them. And so I had to negotiate more. I had to talk to them. I was unable to scare them as much as I wanted. Anyway, the book ultimately is about how the experience changed me. Because I didn't think it would. I thought, this is just a project. I'm only there temporarily, and then I'll quit and go back to my old life. But it wasn't that simple, because the experience made me act differently and see the world differently. And in the book, I try to capture moments where things changed me and where I when I had good days or bad days, how I adapted, how I learned, how I understood that this very simple seeming job is actually a very complicated job. My strategy is to bring readers to a place where readers don't usually want to go, because it's not fun to read about prison all the time, especially a serious book like, you know, a book that thinks about the big issues. Lots of people don't want to go there. I wrote another book about immigration to the U.S. from Mexico, and I also spent many months traveling with Mexican migrants, because it takes it out of a purely intellectual question or political question, and it makes it really personal, because you get to know people, and then to me, this is a good way. These are ways books can bring readers to to worlds they live in but don't know, right? Something right next door that you just can't see because of the way we all live our lives. So I try to, I just try to open some windows by putting myself in these difficult situations.